All right, what's going on, guys? Today, out here on a small little local lake, and I got a lot of buddies of mine that are also professional bass fishermen that are hunting, some that are fishing for other types of fish, you know, crappie fishing, stuff like that. And I got a comment the other day where a guy said that a bass is not even on the top five of most people's favorite fish to fish for. So I want to take a minute and explain exactly why I love fishing for bass. I don't crappie fish ever, like not even once a year at all. I think I've been twice in my entire life crappie fishing. I don't deer hunt. I used to a little bit. Now I don't deer hunt anymore. I've got a lot of access to some pretty good land if I wanted to go, but I just don't like to deer hunt. I don't like sitting still, as y'all can tell in my videos. But the reason that I really fish for bass is the nuance to it. There's always changing conditions. The bass are always changing from day to day, from lake to lake. I mean, from hour to hour, sometimes it changes, especially like right now in the fall where it changes two or three times a day. It'll change exactly how the fish are biting. Same thing kind of happens in the early pre-spawn. So going to kind of just give y'all a couple of the reasons why I like bass fishing so much. Number one is you can do it anywhere you go. From the smallest little pond to the biggest lake in the country, there's going to be bass almost everywhere. They're from California to South Florida, up into Canada. There's largemouth and smallmouth. Everywhere you go, there's bass. So that makes it a very good, like, type of a fish for us to target in these tournaments and stuff like that, which I really love fishing the tournaments. That's one of my favorite things to do. But that's like why, that's what makes that bass such a good tournament, you know, fish to go and compete for, because they can be anywhere, they can be all over the place in all kinds of different bodies of water, structure, everything. You know, we go to some lakes where there's nothing but rock and there's no grass at all, and the largemouth, they get up there on the rock and they react on that a little bit differently than they will on the grass, and they can just get wherever they can on whatever body of water we fish. So it makes them a really good kind of a fish to target, you know, in all types of different bodies of water. But the thing about it to me is they act different almost every single day. So every time you go fishing, it's like a completely new puzzle that you have to put together on the water, on the fly, to try and figure them out for that given day. Then guess what? It might change again tomorrow. So it makes it a very fun kind of a fish to fish for every single day. And it doesn't really get old to me. Now, fishing on the same lake all the time, yeah, I understand, I get tired of the same scenery and stuff like that. But, and I'll admit this, I don't have a super great understanding of like catfish or bluegill or striper or any type of different type of fish. I really don't understand them at an above average level. So for me, when I think about catfishing, I think about somebody that goes and sits up in a spot, they let the bait sit there, and the catfish will pretty much typically be in the same spot more times than not. For bass, it's not like that at all. Changing conditions change everything, and I'm sure it does with catfish too. It's just you don't really seem to go hunting them whenever you're catfishing or bluegill fishing or nothing like that like you do when you're bass fishing. When you're bass fishing, you're really trying to hunt them down. You're trying to figure out exactly what they're doing, and it does, like I said, it changes every day, hour to hour. So that's what makes it so fun. But like I said, if you're a big catfisher man, or you fish for stripes a lot or anything like that, don't think that I'm saying that there's not a lot of thought process that goes into it. I'm sure there is. I don't have a big understanding of it, so I just don't really feel like it's as much thought into that as it is to bass fishing. Now, another thing is just how aggressive they can be sometimes and how finicky they can be other times. It's just like one of the most rewarding things whenever you figure out that one little key that makes a bass come up and just like attack whatever you're throwing. So like everybody knows a topwater strike is like the most fun thing. It, you know, as far as being in the outdoors, it's one of the most fun things you could do. Have one of those giant fish come up on your frog or buzz bait or whatever it is you're throwing. It's such a fun bite. But so many times it can't be the primary bite because how finicky a bass can be. Like sometimes they just won't bite anything. Sometimes they'll only bite small baits. Sometimes they'll only bite big baits. Sometimes they'll only bite baits that are deflecting off something. There's just so many little nuances to it that it's so hard to figure out every single day that whenever it all comes together and you get those ferocious bites, it makes it so much fun. Another thing, there's just something about that bite that you get whenever you're flipping in something or you're skipping a jig under a dock or anything like that, and you've been fishing for an hour and a half and you hadn't had a bite, or you've been catching a bunch of little ones, then you finally get that bite that you probably know has a little bit of weight to it. That's like one of the most euphoric things, especially when you're in a competition, that I could ever put into words. It's just like whenever you know that bite, even before you set the hook, it is so, like, it's just a complete mood changer. It changes everything. Then you set the hook, you get to wrestle them out of super heavy cover if you fish the way I fish. So that's just kind of the breakdown of why I like to fish for bass. They change so often. They're so much fun, and they're everywhere. Anybody from a Snoopy pole at Walmart to a $1,000 rod and reel combo can catch a bass today if they want to, because they're so easily accessible, and that's what makes them such a good tournament fish. So I'm just gonna break that down and kind of let y'all know why I fish for bass. I love it. I love the changing aspects of it. It's different every single day. And when you mix in smallmouth, largemouth, spotted bass, Guadalupe bass, which is something, you know, way down in Texas, and shoal bass, all those different species, even they react completely differently than, you know, any other species. So you can just add that to another list of the variables that makes it so hard to figure out these bass and so much fun when you finally do. So hope y'all enjoyed that video. We're about to go flip a jig around some of these docks and hopefully feel that bite and get that euphoria before we set the dang hook. And then when I set the hook on them, we get them out of there pretty dang quick. So appreciate you guys watching. We'll see y'all in the next one.